Hello everyone, myself Aman Verma, but you all are going to call me AV. And guys, I am here to discuss your weekend test 6 of chemistry. Okay, so let us discuss LTC AIIMS weekend test 6 for chemistry. So guys, in the question paper, the first question that you have attempted is this: which one of the following compound does not follow octet rule? Okay, and I hope you know that octet rule simply means having 8 electrons in the valence shell of every atom. So let us discuss. The first compound that is given is CO2, right? So if I draw the structure of CO2, it is oxygen, double bond, carbon, double bond, oxygen. Oxygen has 2 lone pairs. Okay, so if you'll see about this oxygen, it is double bonded, that means 4 electron and 2 lone pair, that means 4 plus 4 is 8 electron. So this oxygen has complete octet, both the oxygen has complete octet. Talking about carbon, 4 bonds, right? They have how much bond? 4 bonds, that means 8 electrons. So this is also completed. Second one is PCl3. Second one is what? PCl3. Okay, so if we'll draw the structure of PCl3, it is lone pair, chlorine, 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 right? So each and every chlorine has 3 lone pairs of electrons. So I am just marking for one, rest is applicable for both the things. Okay, both the chlorines. Talking about this phosphorus, phosphorus has 3 bonds. Phosphorus has how many bonds? 3 bonds, that means 6 electrons and 1 lone pair. So it has 8 electrons, so complete octet. Talking about chlorine, 3 lone pairs, that means 6 electrons, and there is 1 bond over here. So 3 lone pair and 1 bond pair, total is how much? 4. 4 into 2 is how much? 8 electrons. So again, octet is complete. So yes, obeys octet rule. Talking about the third one, guys, it is ICl. The structure is ICl. And has a very clear structure, that is I and Cl. Okay, every halogen has how many lone pairs? 3 lone pairs. So 6 electrons, 7 and 8 electrons. Again, chlorine has how much lone pair? 3. That means 6 electrons plus 2 becomes 8 electrons. Again, so octet is completed, octet is completed. Talking about the fourth one is ClF3. So ClF3. Okay, chlorine has total how much electron in the valence shell? Total is 7. 3 are been shared by 3 fluorine. Remaining is how much? 4 electron. That will form what? Lone pair. 4 electron is equal to 2 lone pairs. So 1 lone pair over here and 1 lone pair over here. Okay, now fixate on chlorine. Now fixate on chlorine. 1 bond, 2 bond, 3 bond. That means 6 electron and 2 lone pairs. So total has how many electron? 8 electron in the outermost shell. Hence, it does not follow octet rule. Hence, the option is option number 4. Okay, so the 51 answer is 4. Talking about the second question, which one of the following has maximum covalent character? Which one of the following has maximum covalent character? Okay, so maximum covalent character has a very easy way to calculate. You just have to see the charges. Okay, more the positive charge and more the negative charge, more will be the covalent character. Okay, or if the positive charge is fixed, the negative charge or the anion charge should be maximum. So these are some of the concepts through which you can calculate, or you should know that a particular bond has more covalent character. So whatever options is given, I can see that it is sodium, sodium, sodium and potassium. Sodium, sodium, sodium and what? Potassium. They all have charges plus 1. Okay, they all has charge what? Plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. Plus 1. That means the cation charge is fixed. And if anion charge increases, that means we can clearly say that it will have more covalent character. So see, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and plus 1. Okay. So can I say that since nitrogen is less electronegative out of all and secondly has minus 3 charge, so its electronic cloud will be more. Right, its effective nuclear charge will be less. That means the electron will not be in control of a nucleus, and hence the polarizability increases. And since the polarizability increases, that means the covalent character will be more, and hence the option should be 3. So for question number 52, the answer is 3. Okay, talking about question number 53, which one of the following species does not have coordinate covalent bond? Okay, coordinate covalent bond. Talking about first one, NH4+, we know that NH4+ is formed where ammonia donates its lone pair to H+ ion, and hence इट हैज अ कोऑर्डिनेट बॉन्ड, सो हेंस इट इज नॉट द आंसर, राइट. टॉकिंग अबाउट PCl5, PCl5 हैज अ स्ट्रक्चर समथिंग लाइक दिस. इट हैज 5 इलेक्ट्रॉन इन द आउटर मोस्ट शेल एंड ऑल 5 इलेक्ट्रॉन इज शेयर्ड बाय क्लोरीन, राइट. सो आई कैन नॉट सी एनी कोऑर्डिनेट, सॉरी, आई कैन नॉट सी एनी कोऑर्डिनेट बॉन्ड ओवर हियर, राइट. सो यस, इट डज नॉट हैव एनी कोऑर्डिनेट बॉन्ड. ओके, सो यस, दिस शुड बी द आंसर. Clear. This is a complex compound. By default, it will have what a coordinate bond, and even this will have a coordinate bond. So, which one of the following species does not have coordinate covalent bond? Answer is option 2. Okay, guys. Sure. So that was 53. Talking about 54. In PCl3 to PCl5, the hybridization of phosphorus changes from PCl3 to PCl5. So let us go PCl3 to PCl5. Right. PCl3 means what? Okay, PCl3 is of what type? P has one lone pair and 3 atoms. So can I say it is AB3 L type? Whereas it does not have any lone pair but has 5 atoms. So it has what? AB5 types. AB3L undergoes which hybridization? SP3. Whereas AB5 undergoes what hybridization? SP3D. So it changes from SP3 to SP3D. Okay. SP3 to SP3D, hence the option has to be third. Okay, so third option is the right answer. Talking about 55, AlCl3 is covalent while AlF3 is ionic. This fact can be justified on the basis of, very simple, AlF3 is ionic because it has less of polarizability, right? Minus charge, first of all, fluorine is a very small anion. Okay, fluorine is a very small anion, and Al+3, okay, is also a very small cation. So it's, yes, ionic character will be more and covalent character will be less. Talking about chlorine, chlorine is a big anion, and secondly, it has more polarizability. And this concept of polarizability, polarizing power or polarization can be explained by Fajans rule. So option has to be 4. So 55 answer is 4. Next, which one of the following is not linear? BCl2 is linear. How? Beryllium, chlorine, so it is linear, hence it is not the right answer. CO2, again linear, right, it is linear, hence it is not the right answer. C2H2, that means alkyne, again linear, right, hence it is not the right answer. So option 4 has to be the right answer, and that can be easily understood. If we'll say that, sir, it is H, it is also linear, but no, my dear students, it's not the right answer because it has 2 lone pair as well. Okay, it has what? 2 lone pair as well, and this lone pair will bend this oxygen hydrogen bond. Okay, and it will look something like this. This bond angle become 104.5 degree. If it will be great if you can remember this bond angle for water. Okay, so yes, option 4 has to be the right answer for question number 56. Talking about 57, which of the following has a dipole moment? Okay, which of the following has a dipole moment? So talking about beryllium fluoride, the first option that is given is what? Beryllium fluoride. In beryllium fluoride, we can clearly say that fluorine is electronegative, so the electron will be shifted in this direction. Similarly, fluorine is electronegative, hence the electron is shifted in this direction, right? So can I say equal and opposite? And since it is equal and opposite, mu is 0. So which one of the following has dipole moment? It does not have any dipole moment, right? Talking about CCl2 and F2. CCl2 and F2. CCl2 and F2. I can clearly say that its dipole moment will not be equal to 0, irrespective of whatever structure it is. The reason is very much simple. Fluorine is more electronegative as compared to what? Chlorine. Fluorine is more electronegative as compared to what? Chlorine. So they might have opposite direction, but the magnitude will not be the same. And since it is not same, its dipole moment will not be 0. But let's hold on to option 2. Let's see what about option 3 and option 4. If option 3 and option 4 are what? If they do not have any dipole moment, that means we can clearly say that option 2 is the right answer. If we can get some dipole moment is option 3 and option 4, that means what? We have to rethink. So let us go for SO3. Okay, if I talk about SO3, guys, the structure of SO3 is S डबल बॉन्ड हो, डबल बॉन्ड हो, डबल बॉन्ड हो, ओके. सो द वेक्टर इज ओवर हियर, दिस वेक्टर इज ओवर हियर एंड दिस वेक्टर इज ओवर हियर. ओके, सो इफ आई रिजॉल्व दिस वेक्टर लाइक दिस, इफ आई रिजॉल्व दिस वेक्टर लाइक दिस, ओके. नाउ सी इट वेरी केयरफुली गाइस, सी इट वेरी केयरफुली. सी, दिस इज इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट, हेंस कैंसल्ड आउट. इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट, हेंस कैंसल्ड आउट. दिस एंटायर वेक्टर इज अपवर्ड, बट देर आर हाफ हाफ वेक्टर ओवर हियर. सो दिस हाफ एंड दिस हाफ बिकम सेम. सो दिस इज द नेट रिजल्टेंट एंड दिस इज द नेट रिजल्टेंट, हेंस दे बोथ कैंसल्ड आउट, राइट. दैट मीन्स SO3, कैन आई से फॉर SO3 म्यू इज अगेन इक्वल टू जीरो. And since mu is equal to zero, this should not be the answer because we want dipole movement. Okay, which one of the following has dipole movement? SO3 does not have dipole movement. Talking about the last one, CO2. Talking about the last one, that is CO2. Okay, so if I talk about CO2, it is C double bond O, C double bond O. Again, dipole movement over here, more towards more electronegative, towards more electronegative, towards more electronegative. Equal and opposite in direction, that means what? Mu is again equal to zero, right? So mu is zero, mu is zero, mu is zero. That means at least 1, 3, 4 does not have any dipole moment. The only option that has dipole moment is option 2, and hence that is the right answer. For 57, answer is 2. Talking about 52, guys, which of the following has the same hybridization in sulfur as hybridization in xenon in XCF4? Okay, so first of all, the main question that comes is, what is the hybridization of xenon in XCF4? So let us discuss this thing. XCF4, xenon has how many valence shell electron? 8, and 4 is been shared by what? Fluorine. So fluorine, 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 okay, 4 are been shared, 4 remains. That means how much lone pair? 2 lone pairs. So it is of the type A, B, 4, AB4 and L2. And the hybridization is SP3 D2. And the hybridization is what? SP3 D2. So let us see what, which are the options that we have. Talking about H2S, see, H2S will be this. Sulfur has, H2S. Sulfur has how many valence shell electron? Total 6. 2 are been occupied. That means how much remains? 2. Right? So its hybridization will be sp3 because it is of the type AB2 L2. Because it is of the type AB2 L2. So this is not the right answer. Talking about SF4, sulfur, fluorine, 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 fluorine. So 4 electron has been occupied. There is an only one lone pair that is left. There is only what? One lone pair that is left. So I'll show that lone pair over here, right? So it is of the type, it is of the type what? AB4, AB4 L, and hence, and hence its hybridization will be what? SP3 D, and hence its geometry will be what? Trigonal bipyramidal, not tetrahedral. This is just, I was showing it to you. SF6, talking about SF6, so it has 1 fluorine, 2 fluorine, 3 fluorine, 4, 5, and then 6. That total how much fluorine? 6 fluorine. Okay, that means it is of the type what? AB6, and AB6 has the hybridization sp3d2, and hence for 58, option 3 is the right answer, guys. Okay, now talking about 59, HBH bond angle in BH4 is about. Okay, so talking about BH4, total number of valence shell electron for boron is how much? 3. Negative charge, that means plus 1, so total is 4, and all 4 valence electron is shared by what? Hydrogen. So it will have a tetrahedral structure. It will have what? A tetrahedral structure, something like this. And since it has a tetrahedral structure, its bond angle should be around 109 degree, and hence 59, the option is 3. Got it, guys? 60, which one of the following does not show resonance in its structure? Does not show resonance in its structure. Benzene, it shows resonance, and hence it is not the right answer. Carbon dioxide shows resonance and hence it is not the answer. Ozone shows resonance and hence it is not the right answer. The last one is SiO2. It does not have any conjugation. Okay, and hence the answer becomes what? 4. So 60, the answer is 4. Talking about 61, according to VBT, the strongest overlap among the following is, and principal quantum number is not equal to 1. That means we are removing 1s orbital from it. Okay, hence the answer has to be what? PP. Why? Because PP lobes are concentrated at a particular area and their overlap will be much more stronger. Okay, so yes, answer has to be what? PP overlap, direct answer. Okay, theory based. Question 62, again, increasing order of the size of the various hybrid orbitals. Again, this is a theory based. SP has a larger size, then SP2 and then SP3. So no need of discussing this point as well. 62, the option is 1. Talking about 63, the formal charges on oxygen atom in ozone molecule is. So let us draw ozone. Okay, it has lone pair, 3 lone pair, it has 1 lone pair, and it has 2 lone pair. So this is 1, 2, and 3. So if I talk about O1, valence shell electron, what is the valence shell electron? Is total 6. How many total number of non-bonded electrons? 4. Half. How many bond pairs are there? How many bond pair electrons are there? 4. So this cancelled out. Okay, it becomes 2. So it becomes what? 0. O1 is 0. Talking about O2, valence shell electrons still remain what? 6. How many non-bonded electron? 2. How many bonds are present? How many total number of bonds are present? 3. So it is half into 6. Right? So minus 2, minus 3 is minus 5, becomes plus 1. Last one is O3. How many valence shell electron? 6. Non-bonded electron is total 6. And how much bond pair electrons? 1. So get cancelled, 1. It becomes what? Minus 1. So 0, plus 1 and minus 1. We have the option 0, plus 1 and minus 1. This has to be the option. Okay. Since it is not given respectively, we just need to check this options where it is exactly. Okay. So if this question is given with this structure, if this question is given with this structure, whatever I have drawn, I am not talking about this question paper, I am talking about this structure. So hence, here the answer will be what? 0, plus 1 and minus 1 respectively. But since structure is missing, hence we just need to know what are the formal charges, and only this option has plus 1, 0 and minus 1, rest does not have, and that's why that is the answer for 63. Talking about 64, CS2 is linear whereas SO2 is non-linear. True. Carbon in carbon disulfide is sp hybridized whereas sulfur in SO2 is sp2 hybridized. They both are true. How? CS2 structure is this. It is a linear structure because carbon does not have any lone pair. Okay, talking about SO2 has this structure. That means what? SP2 hybridized. So it is SP hybridized. It is SP2 hybridized. Right? Clear? So this is linear and this is non-linear. True. Linear and non-linear. True. Right? Carbon in SP2 is SP hybridized. True. And SO2 is SP2 hybridized. So true. So answer has to be what? Option 1. Got it, guys? 65. The ratio of sigma and pi bonds of tetracyanomethane is 1. Tetracyanomethane means what? Okay, so this is what tetracyanomethane. Now they are asking is ratio of sigma bond to pi bond. Okay, how many sigma bonds first of all? How many sigma bonds and how many pi bonds? So let us calculate pi bonds. 2 4s are 8, so total is 8. Sigma bonds 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So total is 8. So ratio is right. This is right. Tetracyanomethane has 8 sigma and 8 pi bonds. They both are right. Hence, option 1 is the right answer, guys. So, yes, for 65, option number 1 is right. Talking about the 66 question, CH bond in ethyne. This is ethyne. What is the hybridization? This is SP and this is S, right? SP and S. Whereas SP and S? So A is 1. Let us just see where A is 1. So A is 4, ए इज फॉर नॉट द राइट आंसर, दिस मीन्स दिस इज नॉट द राइट आंसर, तो वी कैन जस्ट एलिमिनेट दिस थिंग. ए इज वन, बी नॉट द राइट आंसर. लेट अस गो फॉर थिंग नेक्स्ट वन. पी सी एल इन पी सी एल थ्री, सो पी सी एल थ्री इफ आई एम नॉट मिस्टेक इन दिस इज अ लोन पेयर, क्लोरीन क्लोरीन एंड क्लोरीन, हेंस दिस इज वॉट sp3 hybridize, this is what p orbital. So sp3 and p, so for b it has to be 3, for b it has to be 3, b 3 b 2, this is also gone, hence option 2 will be the right answer guys. Okay, no need to go for the entire question, we can just get it by two answers only. The formal charge for the oxygen atom in the ion this, so let us see. Oxygen valence shell electron is 6. How many non-bonded electrons? Total 4 non-bonded electrons minus half the total number of bond pair electrons. Bond is how much? 2. So electron is how much? 4. So this is the answer. So this is 6 minus 4 minus 2. Answer is 0. So answer has to be what? 0. That is option 3. Okay. So 67 option is 3. 64. Which one of the following molecule has coordinate covalent type pi bond? Coordinate covalent type pi bond. First of all, out of this, this and this, they only have sigma bonds. They only have what? Sigma bonds. So not the right answer, not the right answer, not the right answer. The only answer right is what? Option 1. How come? See. See. Triple bond O. This is the right answer. It has coordinate covalent and that too of pi type. Okay. Next. Molecule formed by PP overlap. PP overlap. SP, not the right answer. SS, not the right answer. SP, not the right answer. PP. So option 4 is the right answer. Okay. Then 2 gram of NO2CO3 is dissolved in 98 gram of water. The mass percentage of NO2CO3 is. So weight of a solute is 2 gram. Person W by W has been asked. And it is what? Weight of solute. It is what? Weight of solute whole divided by weight of solvent. So talking about weight of solute, what is the weight of solute? 2. Sorry, not weight of solvent. Extremely sorry. It is weight of solution. Extremely sorry for that. It is weight of solution. Okay. So it is weight of solution. 2. What is weight of solution? 2 plus 98. That is 100. Into 100. So what is the percentage? 2%. So answer has to be what? 2%. So option 2 is right. Okay guys, clear. The molarity of the solution containing 0.6 gram of urea in 0.1 decimeter cube of water. So first of all guys, molarity is equal to what? Number of moles by volume in liters, right? And we know that decimeter cube, okay, 1 decimeter cube is equal to what? 1 liter. Okay, so weight is given. Can we calculate the molecular weight of urea? If you don't know the molecular weight of urea, you have to remember it. It is 60. Okay, so m will be equal to what? 0.6 by 60. That gives me number of moles. And talking about liters, 0.1 decimeter cube. 1 decimeter cube is 1 liter. So 0.1 decimeter cube will be what? 0.1 liters. As simple as that. So that is equal to what? 0.6 whole divided by 60 into 0.1. That is equal to what? 0.6 whole divided by 6. So this is 0.1 molar. Okay. Answer has to be what? 0.1 molar for this particular question. 71. Talking about 72. The amount of sodium carbonate present in 250 centimeter cube. Okay. Now, not centimeter cube, cubic centimeter. Okay. So 1 cc. Is equal to how much? 10 raised to minus 3 liters. As simple as that. Now what we need to know is what? The amount. So molarity. Molarity is equal to what? Number of moles by volume. What is number of moles? Number of moles is equal to weight upon molecular weight into volume. Volume is what? 250 cc. So 250 cc multiply by 10 raised to minus 3. Because this volume has to be what in liters? This volume has to be what in liters? So molarity is what? M by 2. That is 1 by 2. So we don't know. We don't know the number of moles over here. So moles can be written as weight. We don't know the weight. Talking about molecular weight, if you calculate the molecular weight of sodium carbonate, it comes out to be 106, right, into 1000 by 250. And what is the molarity given? 1 by 5. 1 by 5 is how much? 0.2 molar. 1 by 5 is how much? 0.2 molar. Now, if you calculate this thing, it is 0.2 into 106 into 250. Whole divided by 1000, right? So this is 4 times, right? This is 0.1 times 2, and this is 53. So answer has to be what? 0.1 into 53 is what? 5.3 grams. So answer has to be 5.3 grams. That is option 3. So that is the solution for question number 72. Now, talking about the third 73. The oxidation state of iodine in IO3 minus, again very simple question, IO3 minus. So this is X. So X plus this oxidation number is minus 2. 3 into minus 2 is equal to what? Minus 1. X is equal to how much? Minus 1. 3 to the 6 becomes plus 6 over here. So X is equal to plus 5. And plus 5 means what? Option 4 is the right answer. Clear? Next. Which of the following reaction does not involve reduction? Reduction means what? Gain of electron. Reduction means what? Gain of electron. So, chlorine becomes Cl minus ion. That means it is oxidation. So, this is not the right answer. Oh, sorry. Extremely sorry. The question is which of the following reaction does not involve reduction? And what is reduction? Gain of electron. So, chlorine becomes Cl minus ion. Hence, it is the right answer, guys. Okay, it has accepted the electron. Okay, so it undergoes what? Reduction. S minus 2 becomes sulfur. Okay, or S minus 2 ion becomes get converted to what? Sulfur. That means it has given 2 electron. Here 1 electron is accepted. Over here 2 electron is given out. And giving or loss of electron is what? Oxidation. And yes, this has to be the right answer because it is undergoing oxidation and hence it is the right answer. Okay, and the question what does not involve. Over here, if you'll see Fe2O3 is getting converted to what? FeO. Okay, is getting converted to what? FeO. Again, it is what? A form of reduction because oxygen is removed. And removal of oxygen is also known as what? Reduction. Right? H2 is getting converted to H2 minus ion. Again, accepting electron, again reduction. So reduction, not the right answer. Reduction, not the right answer. Reduction, not the right answer. And hence, the right answer is what? 2. Option 2. That is oxidation. Which of the following nitrogen compounds cannot act as a reducing agent? Very simple question. Just see which nitrogen has been saturated with oxygen. NO can again combine to form many molecules like N2O4. N2O and all those stuff. So yes, it can undergo oxidation. Similarly, N2O can undergo oxidation. Similarly, NO2 can undergo oxidation. That means these three are wrong. N2O5 cannot undergo further oxidation and hence option 4 is the right answer. So which of the following nitrogen compounds cannot undergo act as a reducing agent? Reducing agent, that's why I took what? Oxidation. This cannot get oxidized or cannot undergo oxidation, hence cannot act as a reducing agent. Next, which one of the following reaction does not show disproportionation reaction phenomena? Okay, so out of all the options, the moment I see fluorine, I will go with fluorine because fluorine will not show disproportionate reaction. Out of every halogen, fluorine does not show disproportionate reaction. That is simple enough to understand, guys. Okay, 77. A solution has 25% of ethanol, 75% of water. The mole fraction of each compound respectively is, so first of all, 25% and 75% by mass. So that means what? Ethanol, weight of ethanol is how much? 25 grams, right? Weight of water is how much? 75 grams. So number of moles of ethanol and number of moles of water will be what? This is 25. And what is the weight of ethanol? Okay, let us calculate the molecular weight of ethanol. It is C2H6O6. ओ, सो इट इज 24 प्लस 6 प्लस 16, सो इट बिकम्स हाउ मच, 30 एंड 46, सो दिस इज 46 एंड 75 बाय 18, बिकॉज मॉलिकुलर वेट ऑफ वाटर इज 18. वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट द मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ ईच कॉम्पोनेंट्स. ओके, वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ ईच कॉम्पोनेंट. सो मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ इथेनॉल, इफ आई कैलकुलेट, इट विल बी 25 बाय 46 होल डिवाइडेड बाय 25 बाय 46 प्लस 75 बाय 18. ओके, एंड सिमिलरली मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ H2O कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड एज 75 बाय 18 होल डिवाइडेड बाय 75 बाय 18 प्लस 25 बाय 46. एंड इफ विल सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशंस, ओके, एंड इफ विल सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन, यू विल गेट द वैल्यू एज दिस. ओके, सो द मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ इथेनॉल विल कम आउट वॉज 0.01 एंड फॉर वाटर इट इज 0.089. गॉट इट क्लियर? सेकेंड गाइज, आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू टेल वन इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग ओवर यू, हाउ टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस थिंग. सी द परसेंटेजेस, द परसेंटेजेस आर रियली वेरी हाई एंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द सोल्यूट एंड द सॉल्वेंट इज वेरी हाई. दिस इज वॉट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से. That means, can I say this mole fraction will be less and its mole fraction will be more? First thing that you have to identify in the option is this will have less mole fraction because the numerator will be the less one. Okay? And this will have more mole fraction because the numerator is more. So with this thing, I can eliminate this option. This cannot be the option. Why? Because mole fraction of ethanol shows more. So gone. Okay? Remaining three. See, option three, they are very close to each other. In option 3, they are very close to each other. Secondly, in spite of all this calculation, we know that psi of ethanol plus psi of water should be equal to 1. This is the another method I am telling you, okay, applicable most of the time. This has to be equal to what? 1. Add this thing, you cannot get 1. Add this thing, you cannot get 1. The only option that gives you 1 is this. The only option that gives 1 is equal to this. That is option 2. But yes, I have given you how to solve as well and the logic behind that thing as well. Works. Sometime it works. Okay, guys. So please do all such things. In H2O2 and OF2, the oxidation number of oxygen atoms are respectively. H2O2, no need to calculate. It is peroxide, so it has to be minus 1. Minus 1, minus 1, so option 2 gone, option 3 gone. OF2, we know that X fluorine is minus 1, so it is what? X minus 2 equal to 0, so X is equal to what? Plus 2, right? So plus 2, this is the right answer and this is the wrong answer. Okay, clear guys? Okay guys, so let's proceed with the question. And question number 79 talks about, this is the equation given to us, right? And the coefficient of x, y, z in the balanced chemical equation respectively is. The first thing that I want to highlight is the acidic medium over here. This is the acidic medium, guys. So remember, the reaction is taking place in the acidic medium. Now, second thing, iodine, and only one iodine over here. That means that one iodine is getting oxidized and one iodine is getting reduced. So I'm going to write this equation in this way. I minus plus I O3 minus gives us iodine. So one iodine is getting oxidized. Similarly, one iodine is getting reduced. So I'm going to take it in this way, right? So let us talk about the first iodine. Okay, if I talk about the first iodine over here, to balance it, multiply it by 2. If I want to balance it, I have to multiply it by 2. And the moment if I multiply it by 2, the oxidation number minus 1 into 2 becomes what? Minus 2. And the oxidation number over here is 0, right? So can I say that the oxidation number has increased from minus 2 to 0 and there is an involvement of 2 electrons, okay? And then, talking about this, the iodine is getting converted to I2. For balancing, it becomes 2. What is the oxidation number of iodine over here? Plus 5. That means total how many? Plus 10. Plus 10 getting converted towards 0. Again, there is an involvement of 10 electron, but the oxidation number has decreased, right? So can I say that the same iodine is getting oxidized and the same iodine is getting reduced? Now to balance out this thing, I have to take a ratio. So can I say that it is 1 and this is 5? Hence, this equation has to be multiplied by 5. It has to be what? Multiplied by 5. So what is the equation that I am going to get? So if I multiply this thing by 5, it becomes 10 iodine minus, plus it will remain as it is, 2iO3 minus gives you 5i2, right, plus i2. Right. So can I say this thing, 5i2 plus 1i2 is equal to what? 6i2. Can I say this thing? So can I write directly at 6i2? So it is 6i2. Clear? Let us divide the entire equation by 2 first of all to make it more simple. So it is 5i minus plus iO3 minus gives you 3i2. Now if you remember, I've said this thing, it takes place in the presence of acidic medium, so that H plus need to be added, and how much H plus need to be added will get decided by oxygen. There are 3 oxygen, that means what? 3 water molecules should be present, and since there is a presence of 3 water molecule, I need to add 6 H plus ion, right? So according to this equation, I minus is X, iO3 is Y, and H plus is Z. So the ratio is how much? 5 1 6. Hence 5 1 6, option number 4 should be the right answer. Okay guys, clear? Okay, so let's proceed with the question. Question number 80. It says that chlorine plus this thing, about this reaction, incorrect statements are, we need to do what? Incorrect statement. So chlorine plus twice of iodine, okay, gives you twice of Cl minus ion plus iodine. Okay, so what are the oxidation number over here? This is 0, this is minus 1, this is minus 1, and this is 0. If we'll balance this thing, it will become minus 2, and this is minus 2. I am just taking the normal because we just need to know oxidation and reduction. So from 0 to minus 1, from 0 to minus 1, that means it has accepted electron, and hence it is a reduction. And since it is a reduction, it is a good oxidizing agent, right? Secondly, okay, from iodine, it is going from minus 1 to 0. Minus 1 to 0 means what? It has given electron, and giving of electron is what? Oxidation, and hence it is a good reducing agent. But yes, care must be taken, guys. It is a wrong statement over here. They have asked incorrect statement. So let us see. Chlorine is oxidizing agent. Chlorine is oxidizing agent, and iodine is reducing agent. True for this reaction, true, but incorrect statement, and hence I am not going to take this thing. This is a correct statement related to the reaction, but the question is about incorrect statement, so this should not be the answer. Chlorine is reducing agent, no, means we can take this answer. Second, chlorine is reduced, and hence it is not the right answer. With respect to reaction, the statement is right, but we have asked incorrect statement. That's why I am trying to highlight it, incorrect statement. So hence, chlorine is oxidized. This is the answer. What are the option B and D? So question number 2. Okay, not question number 2, 80, the option is 2. Okay. Proceeding further, calculate the oxidation number for the underlined element in each of the following species. K2MnO4. K2MnO4, manganese, right? So this is minus 2, this is plus 1, and the entire molecule is equal to was 0. So this is X. So 2 plus X minus 8 is equal to 0. So X is equal to what? 8 minus 2, that is equal to 6. So let us see, where is the option 6? 1. Hence the option 2 is right. I don't need to calculate the entire sub. This is very clear. Even if not that, I have a best answer. It has to be plus 1, and at the only place where 1 is present in the middle is option 2. So hence our option is right. So no need to calculate for the entire thing, just be logical enough. Okay, rather you don't have so much of time to do to invest calculation in such questions. Okay, next, so option 2 is right. 82. Okay, the combustion reaction is given over here. The ratio of moles of CO2 and H2O in the above balance equation. If you don't know, I'm just telling you over here. This is alkane, right? And alkane follows this balanced chemical equation. एंड अल्केन्स फॉलो दिस वैलेंट केमिकल इक्वेशन, इट इज सी एन एच टू एन प्लस टू प्लस थ्री एन प्लस वन बाई टू ऑक्सीजन गिव्स यू वॉट एन टाइम्स सी ओ टू प्लस एन प्लस वन टाइम्स एच टू ओ, एन प्लस वन टाइम्स एच टू ओ, सो एन इज फोर, एन प्लस वन इज फाइव, सो फोर इज टू फाइव. डू यू हैव फोर इज टू फाइव? येस वी हैव फोर इज टू फाइव. ऑप्शन इज फोर. ओके नेक्स्ट 83. द वैलेंसी एंड द ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट ऑफ कार्बन एंड दिस थिंग इज रिस्पेक्टिवली. द वैलेंसी इज फोर, सो फोर फोर फोर, दिस शुड नॉट बी द आंसर. एंड द ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट, सो सी एच थ्री सी एल, दिस इज माइनस वन, दिस इज प्लस वन, दिस इज एक्स, सो एक्स प्लस थ्री माइनस वन इज इक्वल टू वॉट जीरो, सो एक्स इज इक्वल टू वॉट माइनस टू. सो ऑप्शन बी इज द, ऑप्शन टू इज द राइट आंसर. ओके सो यस 83 इज टू. 84, द करेक्ट ऑर्डर ऑफ ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर ऑफ नाइट्रोजन इन द फॉलोइंग ऑक्साइड्स, सो वेरी सिंपल, एन टू ओ, एन टू ओ, सो वी नो दैट दिस इज वॉट माइनस टू, गोज देयर बिकम्स वॉट प्लस टू, सो हियर इट इज प्लस वन. Then NO is what? Plus 2, minus 2 goes over there, becomes plus 2. Then comes N2O3, 3 to the minus 6, minus 6 gone over there, plus 6, plus 6 divided by 2 is plus 3, right? What about N2O5? N2O5, 5 to the 10, minus 10 goes over there, becomes plus 10, plus 10 by 2 is plus 5. So what they have asked is the correct order. And every order is decreasing order, it has to be DCBA. Where is DCBA? Option 2, DCBA. Okay, so this has to be the right answer, DCBA. Okay, clear. Next, in metallic hydrides, the oxidation number of hydrogen is plus 1. Incorrect statement, this is wrong statement. Oxidation state of hydrogen in ammonia is plus 1, again incorrect, it is opposite exactly. So the both option are what? Incorrect. Hence option A is, option 4 is the right answer. Okay. Which of the following molecule is non-polar but contains polar bond? Non-polar. Okay. Non-polar but contains polar bonds. Should not be the answer. It is non-polar, but again it does not have polar bond itself because no electronegative difference. This is non-polar. Sorry, this is polar. Ammonia is what? A polar molecule. CH3, CHCl3 is what? Again a polar molecule. Answer is this. BCl3, okay? BCl3 is what? A non-polar. Its mu is equal to 0 but has a polar bond. Why? Because of its structure. See, BCl3. Right? So, if we'll resolve the components, its mu value will come out to be 0. But individually, it will have a what? Polar bond. Individually, it will have a what? Polar bond. Talking about the next one, it is 7. 250 ml of this NO, 0.1 normal Na2CO3 solution, 150 ml of H2O is added. The normality of the resultant is. See, we have volume, normality. Volume, and we need to calculate the normality. So, it has to be going this way. N1, V1 is equal to N2 V2. So what is N1 over here? It is 0.1 normal. What is V1 over here? 50 ml. What is N2? We need to calculate. And what is V2? See, normally the student might make this mistake. They directly take this thing as 150 over here. But this is added. Okay. 250 ml of this thing, 150 ml is added. So what is the final volume over here? 150 plus 50. And then comes the V2. Sorry, not volume. V2 is what? 150 plus 50, that is 200. So, N2 is equal to how much? Can I say 50 into 0.1 is 5, whole divided by how much? Whole divided by how much? 200, right? So, it is 1 za and this is 5 4 za 20, so 1 by 40. It will be coming around something 0.025, mostly this to be the answer, 0.025. Clear, guys? Sure? Perfect. Next. The number of sigma bond and pi bond present between carbon atoms of calcium carbide. Calcium carbide is this. This is calcium carbide, guys. How many sigma bond? 1 sigma and 2 pi bonds. So 1 sigma and 2 pi. Option 4 has to be the right answer. So option 4 is what? Right answer. 89th question. द ऑर्डर ऑफ डिक्रीजिंग कार्बन टू कार्बन बॉन्ड लेंथ इन द फॉलोइंग. दिस इज इथिन एंड वी नो दैट इथिन हैज व्हाट इथिन बॉन्ड सॉरी इथिन बॉन्ड लेंथ इज हाउ मच अराउंड 133 और 134 पिकोमीटर. दिस इज इथाइन इट हैज बॉन्ड ऑर्डर सॉरी बॉन्ड लेंथ 120. दिस इज बेंजीन इट हैज बॉन्ड लेंथ 139 समथिंग. And this is C2H6, that is alkane, that is ethane, it has 154. Okay, so can I say the maximum is 4? So 4, 4, 4, that means 2 is not the right answer. After that thing comes benzene, that is C6H6, 43. So 43, 42, this is not the right answer. 41, not the right answer. Hence, option 1 is the right answer. And hence, option 1 is what? Right answer for 89. Talking about 90, a diatomic molecule has dipole moment of this. Okay. If the bond distance between this is 1 armstrong and what percentage of electronic charge exists for each atom? Okay, so percentage of ionic character has been asked. Okay, percentage of ionic character is asked. What is percentage of ionic character observed upon calculated? What is observed? It is 1.2. Okay, so 1.2 into 10 raised to minus 18, I guess. Right, whole divided by what is, what, how to calculate this thing, charge into distance. So charge is what? 4.8 into 10 raised to minus 10 into distance, that is 1 into 10 raised to minus 8. Okay. So Q into D is this. Let us do the calculation. It is 1.2. 10 raised to minus 18. This get cancelled. Is equal to what? 4.8. That is equal to what? 4 threes are 12. This 3 ones are 3 fours are, that is 25%. It comes out to be 0.25, that is equal to what? 25%. So answer has to be what? Percentage of ionic character. Percentage I forgot to multiply. Multiplied by 100. Multiplied by 100. You will get what? 25%. Okay, so answer is what? 25%. Got it, guys? Sure. 91. In vinyl acetylene, the type of overlapping between C2 and C3. See, first of all, the type of overlapping between C2 and C3, and they have not specified. So you have to apply IUPAC rule. And the rule says that if they are present at equivalent position, then double bond should get the more preference. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4. So the hybridization over here for it is sp2, and for this thing is sp. So it is sp2 and sp. It is what? sp2 and sp. Hence, this is the right answer. Okay, guys. 91. Which one of the following has maximum dipole moment? Maximum dipole moment. So we know that chlorine will pull the electron toward itself. Chlorine will pull the electron toward itself. Equal and opposite get cancelled. So the only dipole moment in this molecule is towards this. Okay, clear? Over here, upside. That means what? Entire electron density has been shifted upward. So this will have more dipole moment as compared to option 1. What about this? Again, if we'll start resolving this vector will get what? Resolved. It's like BCl3 molecule. Its vector will get resolved. The game. What about this? First of all, there is only 2 chlorine and that too equal and opposite. So answer has to be what? Option number 2. That is the right answer for question number 92. 93. In a solution, 10 gram dextrose dissolve in 90 gram of water. The mole fraction of dextrose in the following solution is? Okay, again, 10 grams and 90 grams. So, dextrose is what? A glucose. So, number of moles of dextrose is how much? 10 by 180. That is equal to 1 by 18. What is number of moles of water? It is 90 by 18. Right? Talking about mole fraction of dextrose. We are talking about what? Mole fraction of what? Dextrose. So, it is what? 1 by 18 whole divided by 1 by 18 plus 90 by 18. So this 18, this get cancelled. It is 1 upon 91. 1 upon 91 is approximately equal to 1 by 100, right? And 1 by 100 is what? 0.01 type. So according to me, the answer is what? 0.01. Okay. Okay, guys. So we have done with question number 93. Let us start with question number 94. The question says that the volume, that is 100 ml of aqueous solution. So volume is given how much? 100 ml. Volume of a solution is 100 ml. Contains 10 gram of dibasic acid whose molecular weight is 100. Okay, so weight of solute is 10 gram. Molecular weight of a solute is how much? 100. So number of moles of solute इज इक्वल टू वॉट, 10/100, दैट इज इक्वल टू 0.1 मोल्स. ओके, देन इफ द डेंसिटी ऑफ अ सोल्यूशन, वॉट एल्स इज गिवेन, इज डेंसिटी ऑफ अ सोल्यूशन इज हाउ मच, 1.5 ग्राम पर सीसी. ओके, देन द मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ द सोल्यूट दे हैव पास, मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सोल्यूट. सो इफ यू हैव डेंसिटी, वी नो दैट डेंसिटी इज इक्वल टू वॉट, मास बाय वॉल्यूम. सो वॉट इज मास इक्वल टू, वॉट विल बी मास इक्वल टू, मास विल बी इक्वल टू वॉट, डेंसिटी इन टू वॉल्यूम. वॉट इज डेंसिटी, 1.5. वॉट इज वॉल्यूम गिवेन, 100, राइट. सो विल गेट 150 ग्राम्स. सो वी हैव मास ऑफ सोल्यूशन. ओके, नाउ वॉट वी हैव इज वॉट, मास ऑफ सोल्यूशन. वी हैव मास ऑफ सोल्यूट, सो वॉट विल बी मास ऑफ सॉल्वेंट, वॉट विल बी मास ऑफ सॉल्वेंट. और सॉल्वेंट ओवर हियर इज H2O. वाई सॉल्वेंट ओवर हियर इज H2O? बिकॉज इट्स एन एक्वस सोल्यूशन. सो मास ऑफ सॉल्वेंट विल बी इक्वल टू वॉट, मास ऑफ सॉल्वेंट विल बी इक्वल टू वॉट, इट विल बी मास ऑफ सोल्यूशन माइनस मास ऑफ, माइनस मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट, दैट इज इक्वल टू 140 ग्राम्स. टॉकिंग अबाउट नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ वॉटर नाउ, दैट इज नथिंग बट द सॉल्वेंट ओवर हियर दैट वी हैव टेकन इज इक्वल टू वॉट, 140 ग्राम बाय 18. क्लियर? श्योर? नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सोल्यूट. सो मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सोल्यूट विल बी इक्वल टू वॉट, नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ सोल्यूट होल डिवाइड बाय नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ सोल्यूट प्लस नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ वॉटर, दैट इज सोल्यूट प्लस सॉल्वेंट. सो दैट इज इक्वल टू 0.1 होल डिवाइड बाय 0.1 प्लस 140 बाय 18. ओके, सो नाउ यू नीड टू सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन, एंड द मोमेंट यू सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन वी विल गेट द वैल्यू एज 0.013. सो फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 94 माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द आंसर कम्स आउट टू बी ऑप्शन 2. ओके, टॉकिंग अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 95, इट सिंपली सेज दैट विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग रिएक्शन इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मेटल डिस्प्लेसमेंट, इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ वॉट, मेटल डिस्प्लेसमेंट. वॉट डज दैट मीन? अ रिएक्शन इन विच वन मेटल डिस्प्लेसेज द अनदर मेटल. ओके, सो फर्स्ट इक्वेशन, V2O5 प्लस कैल्शियम गिव यू 2 वेनाडियम एंड 5 कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड. सो नाउ इन दिस रिएक्शन यू कैन सी कैल्शियम हैज डिस्प्लेस्ड वेनाडियम फ्रॉम इट्स ऑक्साइड. सो दिस कैन बी वन ऑफ द आंसर. हियर यू विल सी सोडियम एंड वॉटर गेट्स रिएक्टेड. सो देर आर नो टू मेटल कंपाउंड, सो नो मेटल डिस्प्लेसमेंट. ओके, ओवर हियर आयरन एंड अगेन HCl, नो मेटल डिस्प्लेसमेंट. सिमिलरली क्लोरिन एंड पोटाशियम, सो अगेन नो मेटल डिस्प्लेसमेंट. ओके, सो द ओनली ऑप्शन दैट रिमेन्स इज वॉट? Option number 1, and that is the right answer for question number 95, that is option 1. Talking about question number 96, 1 mole of a solute when dissolved in 1 liter, 1 mole of a solute dissolved in 1 liter of of 1 liter solution gives 1 normal solution. Then the solute is 1 mole of solute dissolved in 1 liter of solution. That means what? All this, what you can see is an acid. They both are 1 mole, that means what? If it is a base, the solution is a basic medium, that means what? It should have 1 OH minus ion, and to neutralize that thing, we need 1 H plus ion. Basically, what we need is what? Monobasic acid. So, 1 monobasic acid is hydrochloric acid, sorry. It's an what? Hydrochloric acid. So, that is the right answer, guys, for this question number 96. Next question. We have a match the following, guys, and I can see the options like displacement, combination, decomposition, disposition. Basically, we need to search this thing. So, magnesium combines with nitrogen to give you magnesium nitride. No byproducts are formed. That means what? Combination reaction. So, A belongs to 2. So, let us search A2, A1. This is not the right answer. A2, A2, A4, not the right answer. Second, perchlorate, potassium perchlorate is been heated and we get KCl, that is potassium chloride, and 3 moles of oxygen. Again, it is what? Decomposition, that is B4, this is gone. Hence, the right answer is option 2. Got it? Clear? Talking about question number 98, guys, a solution is made up by dissolving 10 gram of NaOH in 250 gram of water. Perfect. What we need to calculate? Mass percentage of, means percent W by W of NaOH first. This we need to calculate. Second, and the mass percentage of water in the final solution. That means we need to calculate solute and solvent both. Mass percentage of solute and solvent both. So it is H2O. So talking about NaOH, guys, it is 10 grams होल डिवाइड बाय 10 प्लस 240 ग्राम, सो दैट इज 250 ग्राम्स इनटू 100, राइट? सो इट इज हाउ मेनी टाइम्स, फोर टाइम्स, दैट इज 4%, एंड सिंस इट इज 4%, दिस हैज टू बी 96%, राइट? सो 4% एंड 96%, सो 4 and 96% इज दिस, सो हेंस ऑप्शन नंबर 3 इज द राइट आंसर फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 98. Talking about question number 99, it says that the number of moles and the weight of NaOH in 100 centimeter cube of this solution will respectively be. Okay, so number of moles and weight, and we have molarity of a solution. So molarity is equal to what? Number of moles by volume in liters. Right? What is the molarity given? 1. We don't know number of moles. What is the volume given? 100 centimeter cube. Into 10 raised to minus 3 liters, because it is centimeter cube and we need to convert it into liters, into 10 raised to minus 3 liters. Hence 1 is equal to 1000 times n by 100, right? So with this thing, n is equal to how much? 0.1 mole. N is equal to how much? 0.1 mole. So obviously option 2 and option 4 are out of scope. So 1 and 3 will be the answer. Okay, let us see what is the right answer for this thing. We have eliminated two, remains one and third option. One mole is 0.1. One mole of NaOH weighs how many grams? 40 grams, right? So 0.1 mole will weigh how much? X is equal to how much? 4 grams, right? So option 3 is the right one. Option 3 is the what? Right one. So that is the right answer for question number 99. That is third option. Last one, calculate the mass of sodium acetate. We need to calculate mass, okay, of sodium acetate required to make 500 ml of this much molar aqueous solution. Molar mass of this thing is this. Okay, so we have molarity, right? We have molarity, and what else we have? We have molecular weight. Okay, and we have volume of solution. So we can use this thing. Molarity is equal to number of moles by volume, and since volume is in ml, I'll multiply this thing by 1000. Okay, number of moles can be identified by weight upon, it's molecular weight, it's molecular weight into volume multiply by 1000. Now talking about molarity is 0.375, which is given to us. Weight we didn't know, into 1000. What is the molecular weight given to us? It is 82, and the volume that is given is 500, right? So this is 2 times, right? 2 ones are, and this is 2, 41 times. So weight is equal to how much? 41 times into 0.375. 41 times into what? 0.375. So this is 4 threes are 12, and since it is more than 12, so it has to be more than 12. Okay, so the answer that will come out to be is 4 threes are 12, 4 4s are 16, nearby to, this is approximately equal to what? 0.4, 4 4s are 16, means less than 16. So according to me, answer has to be option number 4. Okay, and that's the right answer for this question number 100. So I hope guys you have understood all the questions right from 51 to all 100 questions. That means all the 50 questions that came into examination. So guys, thank you so very much for watching this session.